what the richest tech booth there is.
It's going to be really sad when there are four flying mandrakes behind that tech booth. But it's a very difficult show. And over here, playing EarthBound with all of us cans, Charlie Britton. Top donations at the end of the day are going to get prizes, including a giant Mr. Saturn. He's in the trash can right now. The trash can is local pickup only. But now, I believe it is time for me to introduce the powerful pig that the kids all did. Ladies and gentlemen, here in the flesh, it's Lil P.
Pitch.
I insist. All right. Space show.
Freedom!
is 1990X. And the only thing there is for us to do is spin the wheel of obligation. Kevin, please come with me to the wheel of obligation. Now, if you've not seen the wheel of obligation before, cheap suit. All right, now if you have never seen the Wheel of Obligation before, if you have not had me explain it to you, the Wheel of Obligation is very important because it is not Kevin spinning it for himself. It is Kevin spinning it for all of you. Because whatever the Wheel of Obligation lands on this entire stream will be called to follow it. Whether it is ruining the game we're playing, thanks for nothing, Kevin, or changing the way the game works, or just doing some weird thing with the audience, you will be required to do it, and all of us will be responsible for what follows. So Kevin, if you are prepared, I would ask you to spin the wheel of obligation.
All right, here I go.
God bless you. Well, you know, great having you here.
Actually, I'd like to bring up, I think we all know that P Corp is overstepping their bounds in the EarthBound Bash and Fangamer. I've actually got a petition here in order to remove them and their involvement from not only Camp Fangamer and the EarthBound Bash, but anything they do in the future. They're uncontrollable. We need to stop them now before they...
Are you talking about the Minch Foundation?
Yes. P Corp, the Minch Foundation, all their subsidiaries. We've seen the websites. We've seen realearthband.net. It goes deeper than you think. Pokey is overstepping his bounds. He's going to ruin the EarthBound Bash if we don't do something to stop him.
Okay. Well, this is a little bad for me, but you know, you won the contest. What am I going to do about it?
You're not going to do anything about it. You're not
going to
stop it.
It's been a pleasure having you here, and I hope you get out of the video and save some time.
This is very important for all EarthBound fans, all of us here at the EarthBound Bash. I'm going to be around. If you want to sign my petition, find me. I'll be around. You're not going to stop me.
We signed your petition. Is that what I can do?
Yes. Okay. I will be around.
Okay. So, Dan, you want to start? Okay, we're going to do it. All right. We got you.
Really hot here in Arizona.
I'm not gonna say anything else. Just get the show under control.
All right. Well, thank you so much. I'm glad nobody could hear us talk because I did not say embarrassing things to my mom. I love you. Bye. So anyway, guys, no problem here. I'd like to bring out our next guest. Our next guest is already on stage. I'm just gonna bring him closer so that you can chat with us a little. And so you can see him at work. It is our own Charlie Griffin.
Sharks, you beat people with baseball bats.
And then I
No, that's funny.
Well, yeah, I have to get a little bit of
experience.
Right, because that's how the game's made, right?
A little early grinding.
Yeah.
So, Charlie, you can talk to me. There's nothing going on over there.
that makes it to where you don't have to do a whole lot of grinding.
Quick question, Charlie. How is Nessa here if he's constantly beating people up in town? If he's just beating up townspeople, is that normal? Is that how the game's supposed to go with a hero?
Well, as you know, a lot of the people in our net have been corrupted by Genghis.
That's true. You don't really answer the question. You could have said it. That's cool.
So, the sharks, they become tame, really. Frankie becomes a...
That's interesting, tame like a beaten dog. Yeah, keep going. These are human beings you're talking about. Just remember that when you say those things out loud.
Why are you on a microphone?
I don't know. Maybe because my dad paid for everything that's going on right now.
So I see where...
You're not even doing just walking around. Like, why is Pokey behind you? And also, why do you have your dog, Pokey? That's an interesting question. What do those two things have in common? Because I don't see a correlation.
I thought it was pretty funny. Everyone was wrong. You see Pokey growls and munches at the end.
Hey, cool, man.
And then he's fine. It's like he's just got all the bubble.
Keep it going. Yep. Right on your paper. Thank you. Hi. Not even wanting to fight you, and you're just gonna bash him. That's exactly what he's saying. He's bash. Yep, just hit him.
The world is in peril.
Welcome to the EarthBound Bash. How's it going?
I don't really need an introduction. I'm just out there sitting down like anybody else. My name's Pokey Minch. My family has paid for everything you're looking at right now. Your salary. You're not getting paid. Your salary. It's hourly wage, and you don't get overtime. So this right here, look at what Pokey does during this entire time. He's making my little brother do things against his will because he is psychic. Yeah, more like manipulative. Let's do that. Let's run away. I think that might be a best option here. But you can't because you've already engaged him. So once you get someone angry...
Like, all right, hold on. Like, how is that the solution to the problem here, though?
If you don't approach anyone, if you're not walking around a baseball bat looking for a fight...
I never just wandering around and then he attacked us.
Oh, interesting. It seems like you've got insight, but still giving you the option for runaway, but you have never even tried.
Oh, sure.
Even has a low success rate. I think you could definitely...
Picky is messing that guy up.
But here's the thing. What am I doing? Not the dog me. The human me. I'm just playing dead. I'm not going to hurt anybody. I have nothing against
you. The human you is playing dead?
What?
Never mind.
Look what you've done.
I didn't
do anything, and Picky is the one who destroyed Sarman Jr. This was not expected. But here you are, getting more aggressive.
I'm being a lot more
aggressive. Every changing moment has more aggression tied to it. Okay, you know what? I'm done. Thank you for your time here. Is this yours?
Yes,
I'll leave it inside of here if you like. Okay, alright. So, again, I'll let you guys enjoy playing this game. How you want to play it. Otherwise, I'll just be going. Thank you. All right.
That was, I guess, Pokey Mesh. And he has very particular ideas about how to play Earthbound. Now, Charlie, I see, has gotten back to it. I should say a little more about Charlie and why he's here. Charlie, as he mentioned, is playing this on his great-grandfather's Wii U. Now, let me tell you a little something about great-grandfather Vernon. And Charlie, you can tell me if I'm wrong here. But great-grandfather Vernon, he didn't have a lot. He came here on Ellis Island like everybody else. He was given a name and a new identity. He had just the clothes on his back and one thing, a Wii U Deluxe Edition. Now, that heirloom has been in Charlie's family ever since. And he has brought it out here just for us. And yeah, I gotta say, Charlie, I'm really touched, personally.
This is your great friend.
He earned it, he worked very hard, and he's been passed down for generations. It's an heirloom that I plan to pass down even further. Yes. Why not?
You know, from the old country where things were hard, but people had spirit.
is he a gamer? Your great grandfather?
What?
Well, he was a gamer.
I'm sorry, was he a gamer? That's what I meant to
say. I don't understand the question.
Did you play games?
Oh, of course, yes.
Oh, okay.
And Luke's are right now.
And speaking of tragedy, something terrible has happened. Now, I don't know if you guys want to hear this again. Should you start from the beginning? Yes.
This is some really deep stuff to lay on a 10-year-old.
Charlie.
Hold on, I have another chance. Hold on.
Charlie, are you sure that you don't not understand?
That I don't not understand. How many negatives is that?
I'm not sure. Just pick one of the options and see what happens. Now you see, Charlie, to defeat Gigas, your powers must combine with the Earth's.
Yeah, I'm that far, yeah.
Do you understand?
Yeah, I think I get that much, all right.
Okay. You're a very intelligent young man, Charlie.
I think you lost me. What's this about stone?
So we'll do a hybrid of all.